Okay, for the uses of organic halides, let's have carbon tetrachloride. So this is CCl4 and trichloroethylene. They are used in dry cleaning industry, wherein the fats and greases are soluble in this nonpolar solvent. So greases and fats are soluble in organic compounds, but they are insoluble in water kasi nga ang water ay polar at ang organic compounds ay nonpolar because of the carbon-to-carbon bonds. Kaya dapat ang makakatunaw lang daw sa greases and fats ay itong mga organic compounds, carbon or organic halides, particularly are organic tetrachloride and trichloroethylene. Now, another use of carbon tetrachloride, they are used in fire extinguishers. But when this carbon tetrachloride reacts with water, they will generate phosgene. This is extremely toxic gas. At ito yung chemical reaction niya. So this is carbon tetrachloride with water, with the presence of heat, nag-i-emit siya ng phosgene at of course 2 moles of hydrochloric acid. Nevertheless, ginagamit din siya, ina-incorporate pa rin siya sa mga fire extinguishers. Now, we also have ethyl chloride. Ethyl chloride is CH3CH2Cl. So we have two carbon atoms and one chlorine. They are used as local anesthetic, which is applied to the area from an aerosol bomb or spray. So itong local anesthetic na ethyl chloride, hindi siya ini-inject. Rather, ina-apply lang siya sa skin or ini-spray lang siya sa skin. Okay? Chloroform also is CHCl3. So this is trichloromethane, chloroform. They are used as an anesthetic, but of course, hindi na siya masyadong ginagamit ngayon kasi extremely toxic siya. Iodoform, triiodomethane, is used an antiseptic, so panglinis siya, pangkill ng microorganisms, and has a characteristic of hospital-like odor. And then we have poly, okay, correction lang dito, this is polyhalogenated, okay? So, hindi polyhydrogenated. Polyhalogenated organic halides, so ibig sabihin maraming halogen, are used as dispersing gases in aerosols, such and known as refrigerants and freons. Okay? So, ang example ng polyhalogenated organic halides, yung madaming halogens daw, is the chlorofluorocarbons or the CFC. Actually, naban na ito kasi nga they are known to destroy the ozone layer. Because the chlorine coming from the CFCs are reacting with the UV radiation. So, kaya nare-release yung chlorine. And then, chlorine will destroy the ozone or O3. This is, yung itong O3 ay ozone. And they are producing hypochlorite. Okay? And we all know that ozone layers are very important because they prevent UV radiation to be coming to the Earth's surface. Kaya dahil dyan, nagkakaroon, dahil sa pagkabutas o pagkasira ng ozone layer, nagkakos sila ng cancer, skin cancer, or human cataract. Okay? So, kaya naban yung mga CFC na yan. At ano ba yung mga example ng mga CFCs? Ito, Freon 11, which is the trichlorofluoromethane. So, trichloro, ito yung tatlong chlorine. Then, we have fluoro and then one carbon atom for methane. Makikita ninyo, wala siyang mga numbers, no? Wala siyang low count. Kasi nga, isa lang naman yung carbon atom sa methane. So, hindi na natin kailangan ng low count. Okay? We also have difluoromethane. So, we have here the dichloro. We have the difluoro, and of course, one carbon atom is the methane or the Freon 12. We have Freon 13, chlorotrifluoromethane. Freon 13-81 is the bromotrifluoromethane. Ito, 1,2-dichloro tetrafluoroethane. Ethane is two carbon atoms. Naglagay na siya ng low count 1,2 kasi nga hindi naman para to distinguish that the chlorine was attached to the first and second carbon atom. But when it comes to the tetrafluoro, hindi na natin kailangan ng locant kasi nga, if you're going to expand that one, that's the ethane. So, nasa first and second daw yung chlorine atoms. And of course, the four fluoro ay attach, dun sa first and second carbon atom. So, since wala nang iba pa siyang paglalagyan kasi apat naman yan. So, hindi na sila naglagay kasi automatic na nandun sila. Distributed sila dun sa dalawang carbon atom ng ethane. Okay? And we also have hexafluoroethane. Hexa means 6 fluorine atom in these 2 carbon atom chain. So, yan yung ethane. And then you have here the fluorine. Okay, so if you're going to expand that one, so you have the ethane and then the 6 fluorine groups, fluorine atoms. Okay? Nevertheless, still, yung carbon atom na meet pa rin niya yung 4-bond requirement. And then we have the last polyhalogenated organic halides. This is the octafluorocyclobutane. Cyclobutane na ito yung ating 4 cyclic structure ng cyclobutane, and then we have here the 8 fluorine. Okay, kaya siya naging octafluorobutane, or commonly known as freon C318. Okay, fun facts, freon, pag sinabi natin freon, this is a brand name of air conditioning refrigerants trademarked by DuPont. So, freon is no longer made or imported in the US starting January 1, 2020. Kasi nga, meron siyang adverse effects sa ating environment and it depletes the ozone layer. Kaya gumawa sila ng replacement ni freon known as R410A, which is commonly known as Puron. Okay, so wala na si freon kasi nga nagdi-deplete siya ng ozone layer at pinalitan siya ng mas environment-friendly puron. Okay? Another use, some polychlorinated organic halides are used as insecticides like DDT. Ito yung DDT natin. Dichlorophenyl trichloroethane. Okay, so we have this structure. And we also have examples such as chlordane, algene, and dialgene. These compounds are very highly stable. And ang tawag sa kanya ay persistent or hard pesticides. Pag sinabi natin persistent organic pollutants, basta may word na persistent, mahirap siyang sa sobrang stable niya. Sabi kasi dito, it's very, very stable. Sa sobrang stable niya, mahirap siyang i-degrade at tumatagal siya sa environment as pollutant. Nahihirapan mag-stay siya ng matagal doon. Okay, persistent pesticides, okay? And of course, binaban na yung mga persistent organic pollutants. Another use is some organic halides are used as herbicides like 2,4-D and 2,4,5-T. Ano ba tong structure na to? 2,4-D is 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. So the parent chain is the acetic acid, and then we have here the phenoxy, the phenyl with the oxygen, and then we have the 2-chloro. Then again, we have the 2,4,5-T, which is the 2,4,5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Acetic acid is the 2 carbon atoms here with the COOH. And then we have the phenoxy. Phenoxy, itong phenyl carbon atom, phenyl or aromatic ring with the oxygen. And then we have the trichloro. Okay, trichloro, 2,4,5. And they are used as herbicides. Some organic halides are used as germicides. Okay? Mixed with soap and shampoos, deodorants, lotion, or mouthwashes. Like hexachlorophene. Okay, so this is the hexachlorophene. It has 6 chloro. Okay. Polychlorinated biphenyl are used as heat exchange agents in transformers, capacitors, thermostats, and hydrochloric systems. They are used as plasticizers, so dinadagdag sila sa polystyrene cups, coffee cups, frozen bags, bread wrappers, and plastic liners for baby bottles. Plasticizers, ibig sabihin, ito yung mga compounds or dinadagdag na ingredients para mas maging flexible yung material na ginagawa nila. Okay? And then we also have PBB or polybromophenyls, PBB. They are used as flame retardants. Pag sinabing flame retardants, dinadagdag sila dun sa mga materials para yung material na yon hindi siya masyadong kaagad-agad mag-catch ng fire. Matagal siyang ma-burn. Okay, so PCBs are compounds can get into the atmosphere from high temperature sources such as incinerators. So, hindi pwede nating i-incinerate yung mga PCBs kasi nga yung ating mga volatile compounds na nandyan, pwede siyang pumunta sa atmosphere at mag-cause ng pollution, air pollution, okay, or mag-deplete siya ng ozone. Okay, so pag nakita natin yung structure ng PCB, bakit meron tayong X dito? Kasi nga, polychlorinated. So, the X represents the high number of chlorine atoms that could be present in these biphenyls. Biphenyl kasi dalawang aromatic ring. Okay?